we're back, and in this tutorial I'm going to show you how to create a text portrait effect in Adobe Photoshop. You will find this image via description link below. Let's start with this. I've called it original in the layer menu. And we press Ctrl T and now resize and reposition it slightly. Let me put the nose somewhat to the center. You can drag a guide to find the center position. Let me use the arrow keys and I reposition the original a little bit. That should be good. The effect doesn't necessarily be applied to the center, but I'm gonna do this in this tutorial. Let me use a quick selection tool. I'm still on the original layer and I select the portrait, so the model and the hair. I wanna get rid of the background. You don't have to be perfect here, but it's a good idea to invest a little bit more time when you select it. When you're done, select and mask. So let us give it a layer mask first. And then we click on select and mask to play around with the edges and make the results a little bit better, especially around the hair. If you've never used a quick selection tool, you can hold Alt and get rid of parts of the selection, and when you simply left click, you'll add parts to the selection. So here we are. Let me activate Smart Radius. And then I use the Refine Edge Brush tool. And I go over the hair a little bit, so the areas where there is still yellow. The red is just a masked area. So red is the color that indicates what we will not see after we're done with this masking process. When you're done with your mask, it's crucial to change the output via this dropdown. So we want to output it to a new layer. So make sure that you've done that and then click on OK. All right, that's a good result. We can live with that. It's not perfect, but as I've said, it's not that important for this effect. The next step is to add some text. We'll use the type tool for that, so press T. I'll type in some text just as a placeholder to show you the effect. The color of the text itself doesn't really matter, we're going to clip it afterwards. But the size and the distance between the letters matters, and depending on the words that you use, you need to readjust it, reposition it. You want to use a thicker font. In this case, I use Casa Ultra FLF. You will find that font as a standard or as a default in your Adobe Photoshop, or at least you should. And as I've said, I now need to resize it a little bit. And if I want to use the center position like this, I might have to add a couple of more words, so that the effect looks somewhat nice on this portrait. So this is the crucial part where you need to play around a little bit and find some, let's say, quote or some words that fit your portrait. When you're done, just hold Alt and drag the masked layer on top of the text, then right click and create a clipping mask. Once you've done that, we want to use the marquee tool and we'll go back to our original mask and add a layer mask to it. So the selection is for the half of the canvas. And I press Ctrl I to inverse it. You need to readjust the text a lot here to find something that really looks good. So I'm not happy with this result. I'm going to add a little bit of text to it. But this is the basic process. And you will find a couple of examples. I've created them for my Instagram. So if you need more inspiration, just check it out. You will find that via description link below as well. and this is how you can recreate this portrait text effect in Adobe Photoshop. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.